Hi, I'm Robbie with Believe in the Run, and this is the Salming Greyhound. So my last experience with Greyhounds was at a racetrack in West Virginia that didn't end so well because I lost my monthly college stipend, but hopefully this one's a lot better. So let's start with the upper. The upper is a one-piece construction. We got a mesh web on the outer here, and then in the mid layer is a perforated foam that gives it that dotted, stippled look like a leopard, not a greyhound. Still a fast animal. Then on the inside, we got a snug booty, wraps around the foot very nicely. And then on the tongue, a gusseted tongue, we have a Swedish flag running up the middle, gives it a nice little accent there. Really like that. Shoelaces are really nice, pretty simple, flat, not too long. A lot of companies are making long shoelaces these days for some reason. These are great. So this shoe does have a 6mm drop, but the recoil midsole adds just this really nice touch to it. It was really one of the most comfortable midsoles I remember running in recent memory. It's really cushioned, but also firm. It's almost a mix between a React and a Hoka. I was actually pretty shocked just stepping into it. It felt so comfortable. And on the runs, it didn't lose that comfortability. And it even offered some really nice pop when you picked up the pace. Vibram outsole, real sticky outsole. It's nice and durable. Really liked it going around corners, especially in the rain and wet city sidewalks. It was excellent, just gripped it really great. One takeaway with that is that it does add a little bit of weight to the outsole. It's a little bottom heavy, did have a couple problems with that, but overall, I'd say the benefits outweighed the negatives and it was really nice. So the shoe weighs 10.5 ounces for a size 10.5. Now, I wear a size 7.5 because I have baby feet, which is nice because my shoes only weigh 8.5 ounces. But for most of you, it's gonna weigh a little bit more than that, which is fine. That's a normal weight for a daily trainer. Now, speaking of baby feet, sizing may be a little off for this. I noticed that it ran a little big. Thomas had the same issue, which we've had with Salming shoes before. I'm not sure if it's just lost in translation or just, you know, variation from company to company. If you're in between sizes, I would definitely recommend sizing down. Even with a heel locking lace technique, I felt there was some room for movement, especially in the toe box. And the collar is a little stiff, especially with the upper, so it might dig into your ankle a little bit if you have to use that heel locking technique. Now, I didn't notice a lack of responsiveness or cushioning after running longer miles, but I did notice that it tended to feel a little bit heavy, mostly because of this Vibram outsole. Adds a little bit of bottom heaviness to the shoe, so you might want to look out for that if you're running, say, longer distances like 15 or 20 miles. Now, if you are running 15 or 20 miles, I will say this is a durable shoe, and it'll hold up over 15 or 20 miles or even 400 miles. In fact, this shoe could even be a Greyhound chew toy. It'll hold up over 400 chews. Or 400 miles. Now, because of the durability of this shoe, it does create some breathability issues. Our West Coast reviewer, West Coast Megan, shout out. She had some breathability issues when running in Southern California. Now, we've only been running with these in cold temperatures here, so I am a little bit worried that come summertime, might get a little overheating there. Now, the durability definitely comes from that Vibram outsole, but the upper is also super durable. You can tell it's well made with really good construction. Now, that comes at a cost. The upper is pretty stiff. That perforated foam mid layer underneath really is inflexible, and it just creates this odd stiff feeling that didn't seem to loosen up even after 20, 30 miles. But other than that, I really like parts of the shoe, like the midsole. I can't wait to see what Salming does with it. I think if they just lighten up the outsole, kind of make this upper a little bit more flexible, a couple tweaks here and there, I think they have a great product on their hands. That recoil midsole, I wanna feel it again. I wanna feel it in more shoes. Bring it. Now, if you wanna pick them up, you can get it in this yellow colorway, or you can get it in the gray slash slate gray colorway. They're both pretty nice. I didn't actually like them that much when I saw them online, but when I got them in person, they looked a lot better, and they definitely look a lot better on the feet. So check it out, the Salming Greyhound. If you like our reviews and you want to see more, remember to like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, and pop a subscribe on YouTube. Kickflip. I'm sorry for this editing.
Okay.
I literally can't say it. But other than that,
we got it.
Do you think that works?
I think so, yeah.